Hey guys, Nick Curtis here again from Alter Reality Games, bringing you a new video about the newest booster set to hit the scene for the Yu-Gi-Oh! TCG in the form of Order of Chaos. Order of Chaos is a great set, highly anticipated, everyone's known about it for months. Finally here, hit the store shelves in the US, so we're going to open it and review the set for you, see what you think about it. As we know, wind-ups get a lot of support now. The wind-up deck has that hand loop to get rid of the opponent's hand. If 2-3 card combo, it's insane. And sectors, ninjas, we got turbos from the underworld. I mean, there's so many great cards. There's so many I'm not naming, obviously. It's a huge set, highly anticipated. Broke record sales for our company. It's just overall amazing. So we're gonna open up a box, show you what we get in it, review the set for you, and give it away to our Facebook fans. So stay tuned. All right, guys, like I said, we're gonna open up the box, review the set for you, see what you think about it, see what we get in this box. And as always, we're gonna give away the products to our Facebook fans afterwards. So make sure you like us on there. The description will be in the box down below for you if you don't know and are not liking us already. So let's get to it. Here's the art for the box. I think it looks pretty nice, actually. Definitely stands out this time. Konami really stepped up the artwork on this set, I believe. So let's open it up for you. Like I said, this set broke record sales for us. Probably one of the best sets to come along in a long time for Yu-Gi-Oh! So, still 24 packs a box. Now personally, I think the artwork on the pack even stands out this time too. I mean, it's overall, I mean, I just like it. For some reason it stands out to me. It hasn't really stood out to me since like Invasion of Chaos. So I think it's really stepped up this set. Alright, so the first pack, we're going over some commons here. XYZ Burst. Armor Ninjutsu, Art of Freezing, bunch of stuff. We got Evilsar, Castanario, and right off the bat, an Ultra Rare number 12, Crimson Shadow Armor Ninja. Anything with Ninja in its name is pretty much like, you know, everyone wants it right now. Ninjas are a good archetype. As you'll see over the next couple months, they'll really start to shine. A lot of people are comparing them to Samurais. Ninjutsu, Art of Duplication, the rare in that set. Or that pack, sorry, not set. Now, in my opinion, I think ninjas are a very solid archetype. We got Royal Prison here. Got a lot of pre-orders on Royal Prison, so let me read it to you. Monsters cannot be special summoned from the graveyard. It's a continuous trap card. So, I think this will see a lot of side deck play. I don't know about main deck play, but it's definitely doable in the side deck. Obviously, a lot of decks out there special summon from the graveyard. Plants, especially. We got a Gaga Bolt in that pack. Insector Hopper. First rare Insector we've opened in the box so far. Insectors obviously are a huge archetype now. Pretty much you need Hornet as a super rare, plus a few other cards. Maybe we'll pull a Hornet here, who knows? That'd be a great card to show you. We got an Evo Instant plus a Super Insector Hornet. Speaking of, next pack. Let me read Hornet to you here. It's a 3-star insect. Once per turn, you equip one Insector monster from your hand or graveyard to this card. When this card is equipped to a monster, that monster's level is increased by 3 monsters. Also, it gains attack and defense equal to the card's attack and defense. While this card is equipped to a monster, you can send this equipped card to the graveyard to target one card in the field and destroy it. So basically, you equip Hornet with one of the other Insectors, and every turn you can bring back from the graveyard and pop a card on the opponent's field. It's a continuous destruction, spot removal. I mean, you can't pretty much free. So, we got Weights and Zen Measures. It's kind of tricky there to pronounce. And Driven Daredevil as a secret rare in the box. Driven Daredevil is a 7-star synchro, as you can see there. Its effect is... takes one warrior type tuner plus one or more non-tuner warrior type monsters to bring it out. This card cannot be destroyed by battle when attacked by a monster with higher attack. After damage calculation, if this card was attacked by a monster with higher attack, destroy the opponent's monster if battled. So it's 2400 attack, obviously, you didn't know that. If it battles anything bigger than it, that guy's not going to die, theirs is going to die. Pretty nifty effect, actually, if you ask me. We got Insector Orb, plus, nice. Ultimate Rare Ninja Grandmaster Hanzo. Someone's going to be getting an Ultimate Hanzo there. Definitely required in threes for the Ninja deck. Let me read this to you.
It's a warrior. When this card is normal summoned, you can add one ninjutsu art card from your deck to your hand. When this card is flipped or special summoned, you can add one ninja monster from your deck to your hand, except Ninja Grandmaster Hanzo. So basically, it's kind of like a strategy searcher for the cards you might need in whatever situation to set up your combos and whatnot. Great card. Great card. Happy we pulled that. Someone's going to get some great cards right out there. We got the Secret. We got a Hornet. Ultimate Hanzo. Can't go wrong with this box. We got Darkblade, the captain of the evil world. From my understanding, I could be wrong here, that card was originally supposed to say from Dark World, and they thought the card would be too good to go with the Dark World archetype, so they changed it. Could be wrong on that. Got White Night Queen. Rare in that pack. Now, this isn't an amazing card at all, but I just like the name on this thing. A lot of people have been talking about this. It's called Interplanetary Purpley Thorny Dragon. Probably one of the longest names on a Yu-Gi-Oh card ever I've seen. We've got a rare overcapacity plus the super rare ninjutsu art of super transformation, super rare continuous trap card. Great in the ninja decks. This card, like I said, continuous trap card. Target one face-up ninja monster you control and one face-up monster your opponent controls. Send them to the graveyard. Then special summon your side of the field one dragon, dinosaur, or sea serpent type monster from your deck whose level is less than or equal to the combined levels of the sent monsters. When this card leaves the field, banish that monster. So there's a white ninja dragon that maybe we'll pull in these packs here. You'll see. That card is pretty much meant to get that card out. A very powerful card if you get it out. Dark Flatter, rare. We haven't had many rare synchros in sets previously, so kind of nice to see one there. Give it easier access to the people out there that like synchros in general. Got an Insector Orb, plus the Ultra Rare number C39 Utopia Ray. It's kind of nice because this is one of the first Zixie monsters that if you Zixie summon with another one, you'll give another effect. Kind of nice. Insector Hopper, one of the rare Insectors in the set. Now, Insector monsters are pretty tricky. They require equipping to each other to get their effects off. You haven't seen many of that. Another White Night Queen plus the Super Blade Armor Ninja in that one. Since you guys like ninjas so much, I'm going to read this to you. It's a rank 4 exceed. Once per turn, it requires 2 level 4 warrior types, obviously. Once per turn, you can detach one Zixie's material from this card to target one face-up ninja monster you control. This turn, that monster can attack twice during each battle phase. Pretty nifty, actually. You get some major damage in with that guy if you utilize him properly. Got an rare Weights and Zen Mains again. Go-Go-Go Giant as the rare. We got ZW Unicorn Spear as the rare. Now this is one of the few sets actually where the rares are actually pretty decent. I'm kind of surprised that some of them are just normal rares in the set. Photon Lizard, 3-star rare there. We got a Gaga Gaga Guard, plus a Super Evil Tile, Najasu, if I pronounce it right. Level 2 Super Rare, it's a Reptile. If this card is on the field when tributed, you can Special Summon one Evil Sword Monster from your deck. So basically if you use him towards a Tribute Summon, you get to replace him with another Evil Sword. Almost like a Reborn Tengu. Not quite, but close enough. Photon Thrasher, the rare for that pack. Down to our last 3 packs here. Excuse me. Vampire Koala, one of my favorite combos in the set. Reverse Buster, the rare in this pack, 4-star. Fiend. We got a rare Insector Dragonfly, one of the cards that are great in the Insector decks. Two or three of, in my opinion. And this is the, speaking of the Dragonfly, this is what I was talking about in combination with the Hornet. You can continuously bring back and pop a card every turn. Amazing combo. And the final pack, we got Shrine of Mist Valley Field Spell Rare, plus a super rare Creeping Darkness. Creeping Darkness is actually a card, I think it's, if utilized properly, it's great for combo decks out there that require darks and such. You can banish two dark monsters from your graveyard, add one level 4 dark monster from your deck to your hand. So it's a searcher plus, you know, you can set up combo plays, you know, maybe if you got too many darks in your graveyard for Dark Arm Dragon, you banish those two, get a level 4, somehow utilize that, plus you summon the Dark Arm Dragon. A lot of combo plays this card is being talked about online with. So there you go, this is the box we opened for you guys. Hope you enjoyed the set. I think the set is great overall, very solid. Like I said, if it broke record sales, it's good for an obvious reason. A lot of great cards here. We got the Ultimate Hanzo, a lot of the Ninja cards, some great Insectors, Driven Daredevil for the Secret Rare. So I hope you enjoyed it. Right now you can order anything Order of Chaos related on our site. We have singles, packs, booster boxes, everything. The special edition's coming out soon, so keep an eye for that. And like I said, we're going to give away this content to our Facebook fans. So like us on Facebook if you don't do so already. It'll be in the description down below there for you. This is Nick Curtis signing off for All Reality Games, guys. Play hard or go home.